Welcome back to the Morning Update Show. I'm your host, Trae Holiday. And joining me for this segment, I'm so elated, one of my big bros out here in the community, Jace and his daughter, Leisha, with the Stay Hydrated, wait,
Be Ready, Be Hydrated
yes, campaign. Yes, thank you guys so much for joining
thank
us today on the Morning
us.
Update
thank
Show.
You thank you.
So you guys are the ones behind that amazing commercial we keep seeing. Yeah. Drink water, be ready, hydrated.
Yeah.
So let's hear a little bit more about the campaign. What is it all about?
Well, the campaign is about the people. It was built out of the community's needs. A lot of times when we talk about health and we talk about, you know, moving our people forward, we get stuck on juices and sodas and things like that. So we wanted to find a way during this time to keep people hydrated, keep them ready, keep them energized, and we wanted to do it naturally. So the Be Ready, Be Hydrated campaign was started by the Vita agency through the sugar tax that was collected by the city. And they said they wanted to do something for the people. And the Vita agency came and said, look, we're going to put together a coalition of people. We're going to work with the community, particularly young folks, and we're going to build something that makes sense for the people and speaks to the people.
I love this.
Absolutely.
And Leisha, why is it so important in terms of really educating and incorporating young folks like yourself?
Well, going off of what my dad just said, I also think it's important because it highlights deceptive marketing strategies that companies use, especially in low income and black and brown neighborhoods. And it also gives them an alternative to drink something besides soda. So drinking 2 cans of soda a day increases your chance of type 2 diabetes by 26%. So just canceling one of those out for water is going to be something that's very important for the youth.
Wow. I didn't even know that.
Yes, indeed.
That's great. And so what has this been like incorporating youth into this process, getting them to kind of get their ideas out here on the table and really incorporating their ideologies?
Well, I think it's very important to get the youth out here. Just like the protests and uprisings that are happening, the youth leading that is important. But us being in support of them is also important. So having them, you know, we got to work with the service board. We got to work with Latino Community Fund. We got to work with Hip Hop is Green. Of course, Black Stacks. We created something called the Creative Leaders so that the young people were the ones leading it and we were in support and of service of what they wanted to do.
I love that.
Yeah.
And so one of the things that you guys actually learned throughout this process is something that I think is super important for our community to understand, learn, and know. Mm. And that is hidden sugars.
Yes.
You guys were able to kind of uncover some things about, like you just said, deceptive marketing practices. And what are hidden sugars? How can we educate the community on this?
Go ahead.
Yeah, I can start. So we did a survey with about 600 individuals. I think it was mostly youth and young people, basically asking them what beverages they consider healthy. And a lot of the beverages that they considered healthy were clear beverages.
Right.
So it's important that they associated clear with being healthy. And that's something that we want to disassociate from, because just because something's clear, there's a lot of things that are clear, doesn't mean that it doesn't have a lot of sugar in the content of it. So we need to educate them on that and how marketing can kind of lead you to think that clear means healthy.
Just the biasness in that, like if it's clear soda, it's healthy. If it's dark soda, it's not so healthy.
Wow.
You know, and you can see that just in how they go to a clear Sprite or a clear, you know, whatever. And then they're drinking, you know, they won't drink Coke, but they'll say Coke is deadlier than Sprite, but they're both the same, you know. And I know I'm not supposed to be using names of brands and things like that, but I just wanted to be really clear about what we're talking about. You know, also juices. Juices have a lot of sugar, so people think if I drink juice, then I'm healthy, but that's not necessarily the case. You know, so we want to have fun with water, find different ways to use it, put fruits in it, put vegetables in it, just find creative ways to make something taste good that you're going to need anyway. People are made up of 85% water anyway.
That's right. So what are some of the tactics that came out of that process that you think really stuck with maybe some of the young folks? I mean, because, you know, you just said that, like putting fruits and vegetables in water. And sometimes, like me particularly, I love cucumber water, right?
Mm-hmm.
But there's just something about it that makes it feel or taste more refreshing, right? I'm like, it's drawing the water out of the cucumber.
Yeah.
Like, it's doing something for me.
Yeah.
But were there any tactics throughout this process that really landed with people?
I would say just having the knowledge is important. I think a lot of times the youth, when they see these influencers and they see sports icons on these commercials, they look to them because they trust them. So having people in the community that you trust to tell you the importance of water is really important. I saw a post today on Instagram talking about water is medicine, which I thought was really important. And I think that ridding the community of that medicine is ridding them of healing and holiness, and it's important to educate them on that early on.
And well, using art is important too, right? Like using music, using visual art, you know, using written the written word, I think is just as important as everything else that we were able to do and the young people were able to express through their way of expression through art. So that was a dope way of sharing with them and the communities that they come from.
So you guys touched on it a little bit earlier with regard to the Seattle's sugar tax. I know that there was a lot of issues. People were wondering how those funds are being utilized. How are they benefiting community? And so I want to hear a little bit more about how the sugar tax was involved in this process.
Well, what we were able to do was get funding so then we could hire out some young people, pay them for their work. You know, a lot of times we get people to get involved with things they love and we don't give them any funding. We don't give them any resource. We just say, thank you. You know, we know you love it. Go ahead and pat you on your back. But with the sugar tax, we were able to bring in other organizations. We were able to fund certain things. We were able to utilize the resources for the communities that were directly impacted by the sugar tax. It was interesting to find out that even when the sugar tax happened, we spent more money as black and brown communities on sugar. Mm-hmm. And it was so the money that came back, now we're able to educate. So we're able to take those funds, utilize those funds, educate, and then hopefully inspire, motivate, and then utilize it to counter market some of this stuff that's happening.
Well, you know, I think so much in regards to like the healthy food movement and things like that is really about reading labels. So I want to ask you guys a little bit about how was reading labels a part of this process? Because I think that when you're talking about the hidden sugar, right, it's really, you were saying, it's just clear beverages.
Right.
They think that when they're drinking something clear, that there's not as much sugar in it, right? So that's like the hidden sugar factor. But there's also things like Gatorade, right? That is like, oh, this has electrolytes in it.
Athletes
drink this. But it has so much sugar.
Right.
So I just wonder how much label reading was also a part of this process in terms of educating community, and especially young folks.
It's very important, I believe. I think that, again, back to education, if you know that your body is your temple from early on in life, you'll know what things to put in it, what's going to give you energy, what's going to slow you down. I think it's very important that even for young people, it doesn't matter how old you are, it's important to read labels and know what you're putting inside your body because it has long-lasting effects.
Yeah.
It's not just that momentary thing, it's long-lasting effects.
And because this happened during this time, this pandemic, all these things that are happening out in the streets, a lot of people were unable to get out. So what we did was we had an experiment. We had one of our assistants go in and kind of do a film, a little documentary of what's in the aisle and turn it around and show them how what the label says, what to read, what to look for. And so we did that type of experiment and it was fantastic.
I mean, it's one of the things that, you know, my son is 14.
Yeah.
And so we're just now really starting to have those discussions where, you know, he's making certain choices that I'm so proud of because he's just like, yeah, I'm good off that. Like, I don't need to eat that or, you know, no, I want water because I'll sometimes eat basketball player, right? So I'm, you know, with the Gatorade or Powerade or whatever. And he's like, I'll do water, you know?
Right.
He's starting to understand that a little bit more. And I think something too, I go back to the sitting sugar thing because I think it's so important.
Yeah.
The dyes that are in certain things. I think that also is a misnomer where they think because it's clear, it actually doesn't have any of those dyes, but I read labels,
right,
and that's not really true.
Right, and also some of the language that they're using is confusing, right? Like we say, okay, it has protein, it has this in it, has that in it, but where's the sugar content? What is the dye, like you're talking about? What are the things that are not, that are artificial, that are being put into these drinks that they're consuming? You know, particularly drinks. We're just talking about drinks, right?
Yeah.
And even water, if you drink water, you know, as an ex-athlete myself, right, as a performer now, drinking water gives you a different type of refreshing feel to how you're able to do then what you're able to do. As a performer, drink water on stage, you know, it gives you a different feeling, you know, it clears your voice up, it helps with the mucus, you know, as an athlete drinking water, you know, you're sweating, you got to replenish what is out, just came out of you. So drinking water is very, very important. And I'm glad to hear your son is doing that.
Yeah.
And there's no crash that happens with water. When you think about these soft drinks, there's a crash that's associated with it after. So it's important that you're nourishing yourself with something that's not going to, you know, have you sleeping on the couch later, you know, strung out.
With a headache.
The next day, you feel it.
Yeah, you feel it. Yeah, absolutely. Weighs you down.
Well, I just appreciate you guys so much for doing this campaign. I think it's so important that our community understand the pathways to health. Because I think that a lot of times right now what we see is, you know, man, we grew up eating the fried chicken the lard and the
That's right.
But now there's a lot of different places, restaurants that are doing things in a healthier way. I think a lot of families are beginning to take that in. And even if you talk about, okay, you know, as a kid, I would always be like, man, if I'm eating dinner, the last thing I want to douse it with is water.
Right.
You know, because like, I need some flavor with my dinner.
Right,
But changing these practices, I think for each generation, it's incremental. Mm-hmm. But then, like you said, there's long-lasting changes.
Yes. Absolutely. And you know, we as Black folks in America, we understand of survival. Mm-hmm. And we were surviving. And a lot of times what we were eating and what we were ingesting wasn't healthy. And now, like you said, now as time has evolved and moved on, now we're starting to understand that there are alternatives. There's different ways to still get that same protein, that same energy, mm-hmm. that same flavor, and we don't have to do it and kill ourselves at the same time.
Right.
So it's just a beautiful thing to watch the evolution of what we understand. And we'll continue to keep talking about this because what's going on in society will not stop. So we can't stop educating our people and making sure that they're healthy so that they can fight the good fight.
I agree with you wholeheartedly there. And that's what so much of, you know, this Converge platform is about, my work outside of Converge. So much of it is really right now this educational piece.
Yeah.
So before I get you guys out of here, my last question to you guys, because we're talking about water.
Yes.
I got to go here. You know, bubbles versus no bubbles. I got to go there. Gas or no gas. I mean, was carbonated water at all a part of this experiment, a part of this project? Because I do know that carbonation also is bad for your heart.
Yes.
So for me, I walked away from the sodas, but I picked up, you know, flavored soda water.
Yes.
Or, you know, plain soda water. But my nurse friend was like, you know, all that soda water is not good for your heart.
Right.
Either. So did you guys go over bubbles versus no bubbles?
Absolutely. Because like we said earlier, you know, people think it's clear, it's healthy. Oh, it's carbonation, that's all right, but it's still water. And you still got to talk about what's being added to that carbonation. Like you said, it affects the heart. We got diabetes as a problem, cancer as a problem, you know, hypertension as a problem. So we got a lot of issues in our communities that we need to really kind of bring to the forefront so that we can be healthy, so that we can be effective, so that we can be active, and so that we can live our lives the best way we possibly can, as clear as we possibly can. And so, yes, we did talk about bubbles versus no bubbles. And we'll go with the no bubbles, you know.
Gotta go with the no bubbles.
Yeah.
Anytime you can get less ingredients in your drinks, in anything you're ingesting, like you said earlier, that's the best thing.
Yes.
Malaysia, any last words for the young folks out there?
I would say that healthy eating is revolutionary, and that being on these front lines with a can of soda is very counterproductive. It's important that you're feeding yourself the right things. And so if you want to be adding to the revolution, you have to be eating right.
Ah, spoken like a true spokeswoman. I love it.
Yes.
If you want to be a part of the revolution, you got to be eating right.
That's
I love
right.
that. Thank you guys so much for joining us.
No,
this has been
Thank
a great
you.
Interview. Yes, I think every time that we can bring somebody on here to really educate the community, educate the public on something that is going to be beneficial and long lasting, we need to do that.
Absolutely.
So I thank you guys for your work
thank
on this
you
campaign
very much.
And thank you guys for coming.
Thank
yeah,
you very
course.
Much. It's a pleasure to be here and I love the show.
Aww.
Love to see you and I'm glad we're able to share on this platform. So thank you very much.
Be ready, be hydrated.
Be ready, be hydrated.
Be ready,
drink
be
water.
Hydrated. You guys, that was the Be Ready, Be Hydrated.